Welcome back to Cosmic Whispers, everyone. Today, we're diving into a celestial mystery that had the internet buzzing and honestly, even some scientists scratching their heads for a bit. We're talking about Three-Eye Atlas.
Oh, Three-Eye Atlas. The alien ship Comet, as some people called it. I remember the frenzy, John. It felt like everyone had an opinion, from it's definitely an extraterrestrial scout vessel to it's just a rock. It was quite the ride.
Exactly. And it wasn't just random internet speculation either. It had this intriguing backstory, especially coming after Oumuamua, which also sparked similar debates. Three-Eye Atlas, discovered in late 2019, was initially quite a puzzle.
Right. For those who might not remember or didn't follow it closely, can you give us the quick rundown on what Three-Eye Atlas even is or was?
Absolutely. So, Three-Eye Atlas, officially designated C2019Y4, was an interstellar object, meaning it originated from outside our solar system. It was discovered by the Atlas Survey, which stands for Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System. When it was first spotted, it was moving incredibly fast, on a hyperbolic trajectory, which is a dead giveaway it's not gravitationally bound to our sun.
So, like Oumuamua, it was just passing through, a cosmic tourist.
Precisely. And at first, it was quite bright, which got astronomers excited. It was predicted to become visible to the naked eye, maybe even a spectacular sight in May 2020. People were hoping for another Comet Neowise moment, or even brighter.
I remember that anticipation. Everyone was gearing up for a grand show. But then, things started to get weird, right? That's when the rumors really started to take off.
Oh, absolutely. The first weird thing was its trajectory and initial appearance. It was initially classified as an asteroid because it didn't show the typical cometary activity, no obvious coma or tail. This, combined with its interstellar origin, immediately brought Oumuamua back into the discussion. Remember how Oumuamua's non-gravitational acceleration sparked so much debate?
Yeah, and some scientists, like Avi Loeb, even proposed it might be an alien probe because of its unusual shape and acceleration. So when Three-Eye Atlas showed up, and it was also interstellar and acting a bit odd, it was like, here we go again.
Exactly. The human imagination, coupled with the unknown, is a powerful thing. When Three-Eye Atlas did eventually develop a coma and tail, it was still a bit unusual. Its coma was described as diffuse and its tail not as prominent as one might expect for its initial brightness. Plus, its orbit was quite elliptical even for a comet, dipping very close to the sun. Some people interpreted any deviation from the norm as evidence of something artificial.
I think the internet rumors really latched onto that diffuse aspect, didn't they? Like it's not releasing enough gas for a comet, or it's an artificial shell trying to disguise itself. There were even discussions about its unusual brightness changes, like it was flickering or something.
That's right. The brightness anomalies were a huge part of the speculation. It was brightening much faster than expected initially, then it plateaued, and then, very suddenly, it started to fade dramatically. This sudden dimming, especially, fueled the alien ship theory. People were suggesting it was shuttering down or hiding itself as it approached the inner solar system.
It's wild how quickly the narrative can shift when something doesn't fit neatly into our preconceived boxes. The idea of an alien ship is just so much more exciting than just another comet, isn't it?
It absolutely is. And it taps into a fundamental human curiosity about extraterrestrial life. But the scientific community, as it always does, kept observing. And the observations, while initially puzzling, eventually started to paint a clearer picture.
So what did the scientists actually find that put these alien theories to rest?
Well, the biggest, most definitive piece of evidence came in April 2020. Instead of continuing its spectacular brightening, Three-Eye Atlas started to disintegrate. Observations from Hubble and other telescopes clearly showed its nucleus fragmenting into multiple pieces. It was essentially falling apart.
Ah, the cosmic breakup. I remember reading about that. That pretty much seals the deal for Comet, right? Alien ships usually don't just splinter.
Precisely. When a solid object breaks into multiple pieces due to solar radiation and tidal forces, it's classic cometary behavior. Comets are essentially dirty snowballs, often loosely bound aggregates of ice and dust. As they approach the sun, the ice sublimates, causing outgassing and often stress on the nucleus, leading to fragmentation.
So the dramatic dimming and the flickering people were seeing, that was likely the onset of its disintegration, not some alien tech shutting down.
That's the leading hypothesis. As the comet began to break apart, fresh ice would have been exposed, leading to sudden bursts of activity and brightening. Then, as those fragments drifted apart and sublimated, the overall brightness would decrease. The irregular brightening and dimming cycles are consistent with a nucleus undergoing a catastrophic breakup.
It makes perfect sense when you put it that way. It's just a different kind of drama, a natural, cosmic one. But it's easy to see how, without that full picture, the alien narrative takes hold, especially since we don't often get to see these interstellar visitors up close.
Exactly. And remember, the I in 3I Atlas stands for interstellar. We've only confirmed a handful of these objects, so every single one is a treasure trove of data. Even if it turned out to be just a comet, it's an interstellar comet. That means it likely formed in an entirely different star system, possibly millions or billions of years ago, before being ejected into the vast emptiness of space.
That's an incredible thought, isn't it? That this chunk of ice and rock traveled across unimaginable distances from another star's embrace just to briefly visit our neighborhood before disintegrating. It's almost poetic.
It truly is. And studying its composition, even from afar, gives us clues about the conditions in other stellar nurseries. For instance, initial spectroscopic analysis of 3I Atlas suggested it was rich in cyanogen, a common molecule in comets. This kind of data helps us compare the chemical makeup of our solar system with others.
So even though it wasn't an alien ship, it was still a messenger from another star system, carrying secrets about its origin. That's pretty cool, actually.
Way cool. And this entire saga, from the initial excitement to the alien speculation to the scientific conclusion, really highlights the process of scientific discovery. You start with observations, form hypotheses, gather more data, and refine your understanding. Sometimes, the universe throws a curveball, and we have to adapt our models.
It also shows how much we, as humans, want to find something extraordinary. When confronted with the truly unknown, our minds often jump to the most exciting, even fantastical, explanations before the more mundane, albeit still fascinating, scientific ones.
That's a very keen observation, Jane. It's a testament to our inherent drive to explore and understand, and sometimes, to dream beyond what we know. The alien hypothesis isn't necessarily a bad thing, it pushes us to consider all possibilities, but rigorous scientific inquiry is what ultimately helps us distinguish fact from fiction.
And with more missions like the Atlas Survey, and maybe even future dedicated interstellar object interceptors, who knows what we'll find next? Maybe one day we will find that definitive evidence of an alien probe, but until then, we'll keep marveling at these natural wonders.
Exactly. The universe is vast and full of surprises. And even just a disintegrating comet from another star system is a profound reminder of that. We might not have found ET, but we certainly got a fascinating glimpse into the lives of celestial wanderers.
Well said, John. And on that note, that's all the time we have for Cosmic Whispers today. Thanks for joining us on this journey through the cosmos and the human imagination.
Indeed. Keep looking up, everyone. You never know what might be silently drifting by. We'll catch you next time.